गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम टू द मैथ्स क्लास ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 4. माई डियर्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस न्यू अकेडमिक ईयर एंड हियर वी आर स्टार्टिंग द फर्स्ट चैप्टर एंड द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज चैप्टर 1 शेप्स. चैप्टर 1 शेप्स एंड इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट सर्कल एंड इट्स पार्ट्स, then drawing a circle, then reflection and symmetry in figures, tessellation and tiling. These all topics we will study in this chapter. Okay, are you ready children? Okay. So the first concept is about circle. So here is a situation. Let's read it. Jocelyn drew around the inner edge of a bangle on a sheet of paper. She got a circle. Isn't it? When we are tracing a bangle, we will get the shape of a circle. Isn't it? Then she cut the circle and folded it twice in such a way that each of the folds passes over the other. Okay? And she folded that paper cutting and she was excited to show it to her teacher. Then what do you think those lines are? Do you know which type of lines she got? Everyone can do it, isn't it? Everyone try to do it and check which are the lines you are getting. Don't you know? No problem. In this chapter, we are studying more about these parts of the circle. Okay. So, before moving to the parts of the circle, we will recall the some topics which we learned in the previous years. So, we have learned about two-dimensional figures. We also know the different types of open figures and closed figures. Let us recall them, isn't it? So first you tell me, two-dimensional figures. What are two-dimensional figures? Yes, the circle, triangle, rectangle, square. These all are the two-dimensional figures, isn't it? These shapes have two dimensions. Which are they? Length and breadth. So these shapes are called two-dimensional figures. And do you know about open figures and closed figures? Yes. What are open figures and what are closed figures? Figures which end at the point from where they start are called closed figures. That means if the starting point and the ending point of a figure is same, then we can say that is a closed figure. And then the figures which do not end at the point from where they start are called open figures. If the starting point and ending point both are different, then we can say that are open figures. Got it, children? So what are closed figures? Figures which end at the point from where they start. Okay, for example, if I am starting from this point, okay, and then it's going, and where it will end? Yes, it will end at the same point where I started, isn't it? So these two are the examples of closed figures. And look at this another picture. And I am starting from this inner point and I am drawing and where I will end? Yes, it is ending at another point, not at the same point. So these type of figures are open figures. Got it, children? These are our examples of open figures. My dear children, can you identify these figures? Identify the following two-dimensional figures as open or closed. Look at this one. It looks like a square, right? या हियर दिस इज क्लोज्ड, हियर इज नो ओपनिंग, इट इज क्लोज्ड. द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट एंड द एंडिंग पॉइंट बोथ आर सेम, सो इट्स अ क्लोज्ड फिगर. ओके एंड लुक एट द नेक्स्ट वन. हियर ऑल्सो द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट एंड द एंडिंग पॉइंट आर सेम, सो इट्स ऑल्सो ए क्लोज्ड फिगर. नाउ लुक एट द नेक्स्ट वन. Here it can be start from this point, but it will never end at that same point. It is ending at the another point. So it is an open figure. Got it, children? Now look at the next figure. It is also starting from this point and it is ending at another point. So it is also an open figure. Got it? Okay. Now, children, we are moving to the circle. What is a circle? Yeah, we know a circle is a simple closed 2D figure. A circle is a simple closed 2D figure. 2D figure means two-dimensional figure. And a circle is formed by joining many points from the same fixed point. Okay. And a bangle, this is a bangle, a coin, a bottle lid, a tire and a ring are a few common items which are in the shape of a circle. These all are some examples of circles, isn't it? And we know a circle has no edges and no corners, isn't it? A circle has no edges and no corners, and it is these all are the examples of circle. Got it, children? Okay, so now we are moving to the very important topic, and that is the parts of a circle. Okay, this is the first topic of our chapter, and that is parts of a circle. So let's discuss parts of a circle. The first part of a circle is center. What is it? Center. Look at this picture. Here, this is a circle, and here is a fixed point inside the circle. This is called the center. Okay. Here, the fixed point O of a circle is called its center. What is center? The fixed point O is called the center. This point is at the same distance from any point on the edge of the circle. So this point O is from the same distance from any point on this edge. Okay, edge of this circle. So the distance between the D to O, A to O and C to O and B to O, all these are same. Okay, so the center comes equidistant from all the points which are on the edge of a circle. Got it, children? This is the center. Now we are moving to the next one, and that is radius. Do you know what is radius? R-A-D-I-U-S. Radius. Radius means the line segment drawn from the center O to the edge of the circle is called its radius. So the line we are drawing from the center to the edge of the circle is called the radius. Look here. Here from O, we can draw a line to the edge. And this line is called radius, R. We can denote it by using the letter R. Okay. And the plural of radius is radii. We can draw any number of radii in a circle. The length of the radius is same for a circle. Length of the radius will be the same for all the points on the edge. And all the radii of a circle are of same length. Children, in this picture, in this circle, here AO and BO are the two radii. AO and BO are the two radii. Got it? So, which are the two parts we learn now? The first part of a circle is the center. That is the very important part. That is the center. Center means it is a fixed point of a circle. That is the center. And the radius. What is the radius? The line segment drawn from the center to the edge of a circle is called its radius. We can denote it by using the letter R. Okay? Clear, children? Now we are moving to the next part of the circle, and that is chord. It is chord. A chord is a line segment that joins any two points on a circle. What is the spelling of chord? C-H-O-R-D. Chord. C-H-O-R-D. Chord. A chord is a line segment that joins any two points on a circle. In this figure, AB and CD. AB and CD are two chords. So we know a chord is a line segment. Line segment joins any two points on a circle. So if I am drawing from this side to this side, okay, if I am drawing here like this, it's also a chord. And if I am drawing like this, this is also a chord, because here these are joining two points of a circle, isn't it? So these also a chord. Here the chords are C, D and AB. These two given points forms a chord. Okay, children, is it clear? So what is a chord? A chord is a line segment that joins any two points on a circle. A chord is a line segment that joins any two points on a circle. Got it? Now the next is diameter. Next is diameter. A line segment drawn from one point on a circle to another passing through the center is known as its diameter. That means the line we can draw through the center. Okay, the line which passes through the center is called the diameter. Okay, that means the longest chord of a circle is the diameter. Here AD, the chord AD is passing through its center, isn't it? So AD is called the diameter. AD is called the diameter. Got it, children? And the diameter is the longest chord of a circle. We can draw any number of diameter of a circle, and it is denoted as D. Using the small letter D, we can denote diameter. And in this figure, in this given figure, AD and BE and CF, these all are three diameters, because all these three lines are passing through the center. So these all are the diameters. Got it, children? And diameter is double the radius. We know radius is, we can denote a radius by using the letter R, isn't it? And radius means the length from center to one point on the edge of the circle. So from O to B is the radius. And here if we are extending it on the other side, we will get the diameter, right? So we can write it as D means diameter is equal to 2 into R, which means diameter is double the radius. 2 times radius is equal to diameter. 2 times radius is equal to diameter. Okay, this one you keep in mind. we can use this while doing the questions. Okay, so what is diameter? A line segment drawn from one point on a circle to another and passing through the center is known as its diameter. Got it, children? Now the next part is semicircle. Semicircle. The diameter of a circle divides the circle into two halves. When we are drawing the diameter, that divides a circle into two halves, isn't it? And each half is called a semicircle. Here, this half portion is called a semicircle. Okay? So the diameter of a circle divides the circle into two halves, and each half, each part is called a semicircle. And the next important word is circumference. Do you know, children, what is circumference? This term is related with the circle only. That is, circumference of a circle means the length of a circle is called the circumference of a circle. That means from this side to this side, this total length of a circle, this total length of a circle is called the circumference of a circle. What it is called? Circumference. Okay, it is called the circumference. So what is the circumference of a circle? The length of a circle is called the circumference of a circle. Got it, children? So, which are the important parts we learned? The parts of the circles are, first one is center, then radius, then diameter, then chord, after that semicircle. These all are the important parts of a circle. So, let's summarize these parts. Look at this picture, my dear children, everyone look at this picture. And here in this picture, O is the center, isn't it? O is the fixed point of the circle. So, O is the center, and OA, that is the distance from center to one point in the edge of the circle, that is the radius. So, OA is the radius. Okay, OA is the radius. Now, look here, BC. Here a line is passing through the center. So, this line is called the diameter. Just now we learned, the line which passes through the center is called the diameter. So, BC is the diameter. Now, DE. Here, the DE is the chord. What is a chord? The two points of a circle is joined by using this line. So this is called the chord. Okay, it is a chord. Now BFC. Here the diameter BC is the diameter that we know, isn't it? BC divides this circle into two equal halves, that is BFC. This is the one half and this is the another half. So here BFC is a semicircle. What is the name for this? It's a semicircle. Got it, children? So these all are the main parts we learned. Got it? Okay, my dears, I hope it is clear for you. Now, I am giving you some notebook work. Everyone copy this, closed figures and open figures. That you can write first. After that, write the circle knot. After that, parts of a circle. My dears, I marked knots by using the highlighter. That is yellow colored lines you can copy in parts of a circle. Okay, and now I am going to give you a workbook activity also. The first three questions you can answer in the workbook itself. So I am winding up today.